pill to my trembling lips. How did the night ever get like this? One shot and the whiskey goes down, down, down. Bottom of the bottle hits, waking up my mind as I throw a fit. The waking is taking me down, down, down. My heart's beating faster, I know what I'm after. I've been standing here my whole life. Everything I've seen twice. Now it's time I realize it's spinning back around. My name is Adam, and today we're going to be playing some game. We're going to be playing some game. Some game, guys. Don't you love it when you just play game? anyway. today we're going to be playing some the Stanley Parable. I have no fucking clue about what this game actually is. And currently I'm bleeding. That's why I'm not straight up switching it over to the live. I'm currently fucking bleeding, so I have to take care of that real quick. Yep. Yeah, it's fine. Switch over to the live. Also, my hair looks different. It's because my fucking hair has been all over the place, so I had to comb it down. I hate combing my hair, but what can you do? What can you do except for die? Anyway. Yeah. So today we're going to be playing the Stanley Parable. I don't know. Man, I don't know what this game is. I really don't. Okay. Seriously, I'm bleeding on my arm, guys. Dead eyes bleeding on my arm over here. So I'm sorry. So today we are going to be playing some Stanley Parable. Let's just see if it loads up right here. Oh, that is weird. What the hell? Wait. Is there a way to make the aspect ratio bigger? See, this is what happens when you don't do shit beforehand.
Yeah, so...
Okay. Change the aspect ratio, meaning the aspect ratio in here, Chao. Good fucking Lord Almighty. This is why you do shit before the live stream. This is what those moments before the live stream are for. But no, my dumbass doesn't think about that, does he? No, honey, no. Look how fucking small this will be. Oh my god. Things I do for YouTube. Sure. We'll do it at that. Fucking. I'm sorry, guys. That's gonna be the aspect ratio. It doesn't fucking want to work right now, so. What can you do except work with it? Because that's all you really, in the end, have to do. You work with it. You work with it. You have it. Perfection. So, yeah. That should be good for what it is. Hey, Lazari, how are you? Yes, I do. Of course I remember you. Lazari, just because you're not here every stream doesn't mean I forget you. I don't forget anyone, purposely. Haha, I wish. Certain people are wanting to forget. Got my nice water, because I can't, I'm not doing drinking anymore, because fuck that. Yeah. So yeah, I remember you, Lazari. How are you doing? Of course I remember you. I've already said that. You told me not to pull out my teeth. Yes, I did. And did you heed my warning, or are you still pulling out your fucking teeth? Are you still pulling out, still doing teeth, or just fucking not? Because I'd rather you not, you see. I'd just rather you not do that, you know? I don't know. That I don't know. I don't like people pulling out teeth. Yeah. Fucking hell. Yeah. Well, I'm doing good. Great. That's always good, right? It's always good to hear. Ugh, my head hurts for what I just did. So I've decided, hey, why not? I have no hilly teeth, so no. Good. Good. You're damn right, good. Okay. I think we should just get into Stanley Parable. I've never played this game before, so... And I haven't watched any videos either, so that's... Okay. What's extras? Achievements? Achievement unlocked. Achievement. Saves enabled. Sure. You are playing Stanley Parable. What the fuck is this game? The end is never. The end is loading. The end is never. What? Never the end is never the end is never. Oh, is load. Wait, the end is load. It's never. Oh my god, my fucking head hurts. Someone help. I don't know what I'm doing and I'm afraid. And who left me a room alone? Mommy? Someone help me. Yo, I'm thinking about working out soon, though. I swear, I gotta start doing that. I gotta start getting those gains, bro. If I could put that down. But yeah. I'm also thinking about getting a haircut, but again, I'm not sure. Stanley Parable, work. Pretty please with a sugary thing on top. I don't give a fuck. Hey, my thing is not bleeding anymore, so that's great. No one likes the sight of blood because fuck that. It's literally not long up, so I mean, what can I do here? I also didn't pre-test this game, so I've done fucked it. If it doesn't work, it's completely my fault. But currently, it's stuck on one screen, so I'm gonna try. Here, you guys look over there for a second. You know, just look at the wall for a second. While I reconnect my entire goddamn monitor to this shit. Actually, here, you guys can come over here and look at me. A beautiful. Oh god, I'm all the way up here. Oh god. Okay, I thought I was fucking hitting my water, but I'm like, my water's over there. Okay, reconnect that. The hell is happening to my computer right now? I swear to God. It does this every time. It does bitch boy do. Oh my God. I'm sorry, guys. My fucking computer wants to be a bitch right now, so what can I do? What can I do except comply to its every order and demand? Why is it saying no signal again? Fucking connect that shit. It's literally... Here, guys. You want to go and see? You want to go and see this shit, what I'm seeing right now? That's what I'm seeing. Someone help my fucking life. I broke it. Guys, I broke it. I broke my computer. I want to kill myself. Okay, I'm not sure. The first 15 minutes of this goddamn live stream will be me figuring out this shit. Because fuck me in the ass and call me Patricia. I'm not sure. There we go. Now it's working with that. Okay, there. Look at that. It's beautiful. My God. Whew. My God, it's finally up again. So, there's that part of this whole situation done. Okay, for a second there, I thought I did not unmute my mic. If I did not unmute my mic, oh, how everything would have gone to shit. What the hell is happening in the chat? Okay, so let me just catch up with the chat. Hey, Smash Mouth, how are you? Smash Mouth Egg, how are you doing? Oh, interesting. You reply for a dev for a brawl mod? Interesting. Lazari, what the fuck, Lazari? You're practically a vampire. You drink. Oh my God. Don't hurt yourself. Trust me when I say that. Do not hurt yourself. My dude, you can't say that. Oh my God. Dead. No. Honey, no. Honey, no. Honey, no. Fuck's sake. Oh my God. Biggity fuck is happening. Oh my God. Okay. Whew. Let's try and get back in because it's still a game. It's still a game, you know. It's fucking... I cannot speak. Okay. Let's see. Let's just leave it going. And the black screen again. Motherfucker. Oh, hey, it's actually loading now. You can see it down there. It's loading. It loaded.
Click this skip. Is the story of a man named Stanley.
Stanley? Oh, hell yeah.
Stanley worked for a company in a big building where he was employee number 427.
Okay.
Employee number 427's job was simple. He sat at his desk in room 427 and he pushed buttons on a keyboard. Orders came to him through a monitor on his desk, telling him what buttons to push, how long to push them, and in what order. This is what employee 427 did every day of every month of every year.
And although
others might have considered it soul-rending, Stanley relished every moment that the orders came in, as though he had been made exactly for this job. And Stanley was happy.
That room was by itself. The Stanley.
And then one day, something very peculiar happened. Something that would forever change Stanley. Something he would never quite forget. He had been at his desk for nearly an hour when he realized that not one single order had arrived on the monitor for him to follow. No one had showed up to give him instructions, call a meeting, or even say, hi. Never in all his years at the company had this happened. This complete isolation. Something was very clearly wrong. Shocked, frozen solid, Stanley found himself unable to move for the longest time. But as he came to his wits and regained his senses,
oh God.
He got up from his desk and stepped out of his office.
Guys, watch this. I'm gonna... You see how much I keep on moving, the stop distance there? Look at that. Fucking, I just keep on going forward. Okay, I think I'm on fucking ice. So they got up from your desk and go into there. I want just Let me jump through the window.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
No, I don't wanna.
No matter how hard Stanley looked, he couldn't find a trace of his co-workers.
What's that? Can you guys read that? I can't read it. Looks like something downloading. Why is it so fucking bright? Okay, I guess we're going this way then. We get there? No. 420, bro!
Stanley went around touching every little thing in the office, but it didn't make a single difference, nor did it advance the story in any way.
I'll do whatever the hell I want, narrator, motherfucker. Okay, I guess we're going... Let's go over here. What is this place? This place is making my head hurt. It hurts, I tell you. I hate Mondays. Don't we all? Oh my god. Oh my god. Looks like, yeah. I'm not sure. Fucking hell. Also, I'm serious. I'm sorry about the resolution, guys. It's just fucking... There's nothing I can do about the resolution. That's the highest it will go currently. So what do you want from me? To fix the resolution. That's what you guys want from me, but... I wish I could do that. Okay, let me just load up the game again. That's what happens whenever I get out of the game. I have to load up the damn game again. Now I'm sad. Okay. Where we are. Going this way. 416. What the fuck? What the fuck is that? Do you see that? What's in there? It doesn't look like a regular office building.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Left.
Left. This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Left.
Ah, yes, truly a room worth admiring. It had really been worth the detour after all, just to spend a few moments here in this immaculate, beautifully constructed room. Yeah. Stanley simply stood here, drinking it all in.
Quite literally, we have coffee on the table. It looks like full. Oh my god, I thought that said AIDS.
Really, really worth it being here in the room. A room so utterly captivating that even though all your co-workers have mysteriously vanished, here you sit looking at these chairs and some paintings.
Shut the fuck up, narrator. I want to narrate here. Shut up. Coffee nut. All that for a second.
But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Nope. Fuck you.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't fired years ago.
Caution, do not lie. If you're lying right now, stop. You hear that, guys? If you're lying right now, stop. Oh my god. What the fuck? Smash Mouth, like, what? I'm confused. What does that mean? You're able to open up command prompt via. You should be able to go into TV. Where the fuck? I don't understand. Gotta get back in the game before I can do any command prompts, apparently. I'm so confused at what you're talking about, though. I don't know the command prompts. Okay. Yeah, I don't know. Well. Oh god, why does the door keep on closing behind me? I swear. This is not good for my health. Okay, wait. Warning, do not jump from cargo with moving will cause death. Penalty for misuse of cargo lift. For 1,000 penalty for jumping off the cargo lift. Penalty for jumping off the cargo lift will pay more than a $5,000 fee. You're gonna die.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here.
Fuck you, narrator!
But in his eagerness to prove that he is in control of the story and no one gets to tell him what to do, Stanley leapt from the platform and plunged to his death. Good job, Stanley. Everyone thinks you are very powerful.
Fucking yeah, dude. I'm so powerful I jumped off a building. Oh my god. Yeah, exactly, Azari. Exactly. If you're an idiot, then you're Adam. If you have a blubber layer, then you're really... And they're really weird, then you're Adam. Damn right I am. Fucking hell. I'm gonna take that as a compliment. Because fuck it. I do have a weird blubbery layer, I swear. Okay. Oh, we're back all the way at the control room. This is what
all
happens
of his
when you...
co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
You can't jump. That's an achievement unlocked. Wait, how many achievements are there? Okay, can I just close that? Close that, okay. Beat the game. Okay, view all achievements, maybe? No. Whatever, I'll check them later. And I can't run either.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Let's just do what the narrator says. Let's be obedient, little boy.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
Let it ball up inside you, take it out. Passive aggressively on other coworkers. Resent coworkers who are not supporting you more. Let using side sister. Make sure your side has sleek blue graphic. Calm, productive work environment. That is not calm. Everyone is unique, and you most of all. What the fuck is this? Can I go into the broom closet?
Stanley stepped into the broom closet, but there was nothing here, so he turned around and got back on track.
No, I don't believe it. I don't believe that there's nothing here.
There was nothing here. No choice to make, no path to follow, just an empty broom closet.
No.
No reason to still be here.
I don't believe it. Fine.
It was baffling that Stanley was still just sitting in the broom closet.
Shut the fuck
he
up.
Wasn't even doing anything. At least, coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Nope. Yep, nope. If anything, if horror movies have taught me anything, you do not go down into the basement. Thank you very much. Okay. Up this area. Well, this looks warm and inviting. Executive bathroom. I need to go use the bathroom. God, it's always creepy. Oh god.
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this. What dark secret was being held from him? What he could not have known was that the keypad behind the boss's desk guarded the terrible truth that his boss had been keeping from him. And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number. 2845.
2845.
But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this.
2845. 2845, I think. I don't know where the fuck... Oh.
Stanley just
oh my god!
Sums. Trying to input anything on the device was useless, since
two,
he could never possibly know
eight,
that the combination
four,
was 2845.
I misclicked. Okay, 2485.
Stanley simply began entering 2845.
2845. I'm a dumbass. I'm sorry.
Yet incredibly, by simply pushing random buttons on the keypad, Stanley happened to input the correct code by sheer luck. Amazing. He stepped into the newly opened passageway.
Oh. Well then. This is not ominous as shit. Nah, dude, not at all. You're 2845. 2845. I'm sorry, guys. 2845. I'm sorry, okay? I have bad memory. What the fuck is this game, though? Like, I commit. Okay, we're going this way. Do we go down the long elevator of death? Eh, fuck it. I always wanted to die. Oh, God. No, let me out. I don't want to be in here anymore. I have a fear of elevators. I have a fear of tight spaces. Oh, God. And we're back to the loading screen. Great. We're going to be sitting here for another hour, guys. Like, it's the same kind of loading screen that was at the beginning of the video, so... Oh, wait, nope. Nope, it's loading, though. It's a loady boy. I think. Yes, it is a loady boy. We love loady boys, don't we? This is a very strange game. Someone help me out. This is a very strange game, and I'm afraid for my life. Okay. It's not loading. Okay, there we go. It's almost there.
Descending deeper into the building, Stanley realized he felt a bit peculiar. It was a stirring of emotion in his chest, as though he felt more free to think for himself, to question the nature of his job. Why did he feel this now, when for years it had never occurred to him? This question would not go unanswered for long.
Oh.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
Escape! Yes, I want to escape!
Although this passageway had the word escape written on it, the truth was that at the end of this hall, Stanley would meet his violent death.
Eh, fuck it, I always wanted to die.
The door behind him was not shut. Stanley still had every opportunity to turn around and get back on track.
So how are you guys doing?
At this point, Stanley was making a conscious, concerted effort to walk forward and willingly confront his death.
You guys doing good? Yeah, I was just walking through my death. Did I die or no? Please and thank you. Okay. So it seems like there are several endings to this. If this doesn't kill me, then there seems like there are several endings to this game. Maybe. I don't know. Loading, 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 loading. Oh, God. I can't.
As the machine whirred into motion and Stanley was inched closer and closer to his demise, he reflected that his life had been of no consequence whatsoever.
No,
wait. Stanley can't see the bigger picture. He doesn't know the real story, trapped forever in his narrow vision of what this world is.
Oh, my God.
Perhaps his death was of no great loss, like plucking the eyeballs from a blind man. So he resigned and willingly accepted this violent
No.
There now, Stanley.
Oh! Oh!
Farewell, Stanley, cried the narrator, As Stanley was led helplessly into the enormous metal jaws. In a single visceral instant, Stanley was obliterated as the machine crushed every bone in his body, killing him instantly.
What? What?
And yet it would be just a few minutes before Stanley would restart the game, back in his office, as alive as ever. What exactly did the narrator think he was going to accomplish?
The Stanley Parable, you motherfucker.
When every path you can walk has been created for you long in advance, death becomes meaningless, making life the same. Do you see now? Do you see that Stanley was already dead from the moment he hit start?
Stanley's gonna be... What the fuck? Yo, what? Yo. Yo, no, no, honey, no. You can't even open these doors! What the... Button sounds. What? Yo, what? Off the computer. Employee day... Okay, let's just turn them off. Okay, what does that actually say? Fuck it. We'll never know, guys. Does that piss you off at all, guys? Loading, 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 loading. Loading, 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 loading. Is that getting annoying yet, guys? Hell, it was annoying an hour ago. Okay. Okay. What are these? The boss's office. Oh. Office clock. So these are like game assets, I would think. Like, that's what it's trying to say. These are game assets. Freedom Ending. This was the very first incarnation of Freedom Ending in the game alpha. Okay. Countdown desk. What is this one earlier? Okay. Freedom Ending. When I press the button. Monitor room elevator. When I press. God, this is reminding me. If anyone played Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 and they had the museum at the end, that's what this game is reminding me of now. Game design mock-up. This little. What the fuck, man? What the fuck, Richard? This way, maybe? Exit! Stanley Parable!
Oh, look at these two. How they wish to destroy one another. How they wish to control one another. How they both wish to be free.
Oh, God. We say no more to games controlling us!
Can you see? Can you see how much they need one another?
Nope.
No, perhaps not. Sometimes these things cannot be seen. But listen to me. You can still save these two. You can stop the program before they both fail. Push escape and press quit. There's no other way to beat this game.
I won't do it.
As long as you move forward, you'll be walking someone else's path. Stop now, and it'll be your only true choice. Whatever you do, choose.
Don't look at it!
Don't let time choose for you. Don't let time.
Splat. Curse splat, boys and girls. Can I murder you? Eh. I mean, several people have tried to murder me already, so come on down. It's not like I have anything against it. This, I just went kersplat. Now it's just loading up again. And yes, I'm chewing on a fucking tire right now. I'm nervous. I just went kersplat, guys. I'm sorry. I'm sorry if I'm a little bit nervous after going kersplat. My dude! This is literally the game, guys, now. You wait kersplat, and you died. God damn it. Okay, let's begin the game again. The end is never, the end is loading. Okay. It's loading never. So I went kersplat, and now we have to reset the game. Great. Don't you guys ever have those issues where you just go kersplat, and then you have to start the game over? It's a hard enough life for me. It's a hard enough life for me. Oh my god. What the fuck is this game? It's a hard enough life for me. I know how I have no better jokes. And me. Okay, let's try this again. Because Rome.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
Wait, did I actually... What do you mean I didn't beat the game? You know what? I'm actually going into the fucking Steam thing and seeing the achievements there. So I want to see the achievements, damn it. Okay. Maybe. I don't know. Okay. I realize I'm not doing anything to that. I'm sorry. Just looking at some stuff. What the fuck, Richard? I don't know. Where is it? This is the parable. It's all the way down here. This one. Do all achievements. Achievements. What we gave me up. 8888. Oh no. Click on a door 430 times. Who wants me to actually do that? Because I can click the door, you know. I'm doing it. Fuck you guys, I'm doing it. I'm clicking a damn door 430 times.
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
You know, I clicked on an auto clicker for this. I'm not going to. But just realized I could. This is what my life devolves to, guys. Looking at a door and clicking a button. Just for a damn achievement.
Stanley stood for a long time in one spot. It's part of the game. He likes to see how long he can go without dying. So far, he's doing excellent. And if he just stays right where he is, I'm sure he'll keep up that good momentum. Let's observe the genius at work.
Okay, you know what? I'm really sick and tired of this game. So, what we're going to do... If we're not going to do that, is what we're going to do. Is I'm wondering if I can get this to work. I need to open up this. Pretty please, open up the damn thing. If so, if this works, then everything goes to plan. Okay. Oh my god, will you just fucking open the thing? Okay. Can just ask for it. There we go. Open that. Oh, god damn it. Oh my god. There we go. Okay. I don't want that. Oh my god. If you would actually... Fuck. Okay, you know what? We're not doing that. We're just going to play the game for a little bit more until we decide to end. Because we're not clicking a goddamn door 400. Wait. I need to find something now. 16, 15, that would be it back here. If what I'm thinking is true, then this game is a bitch.
Oh, please. Are you really just doing this for the achievement? Click a door 5 times. Is that all that you think an achievement is worth? No. I can't just give these merits away for such little effort. A measly 5 clicks. Now, suppose you were to click the door 20 times. I would say that's the kind of effort that warrants recognition.
I hate this narrator.
I have to say, I'm still not feeling the satisfaction of witnessing true effort for a noble cause. Perhaps 50 clicks will do it. Yes, almost certainly 50 clicks.
I'm gonna beat him. I'm gonna beat his own game. I'm not backing down. This motherfucker wants to talk big. I'm gonna do
no,
big.
No, I'm still not feeling it. I want this achievement to have meant something. It has to be a true reward for
it
valiant
means
effort.
Something.
I want to see some hustle, Stanley. I want to see commitment, a willingness to go all the way, no matter what the cost. Why don't you go put 20 clicks into door number 417?
417? That's 417. You know what? I do what he tells me to do. He is Almighty God. It's 417.
Oh, great. Now, go click a few times on door 437.
413? Oh, wait, no, 431. 431? There's no such thing at 431. What, is there? 29, 28, 431. But there is no door of 431. Where is door for 431? Where is 431? Is it over here? No. I don't understand. Fuck this. Fuck you, narrator.
When Stanley came to a set
of
two
shit,
open doors,
go
this was not the correct
you.
Way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. Wow. Yes. This room. But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
I'm completely ignoring what the narrator says. Fuck that guy. Fucking give me a
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
Yep.
Looks...
Okay. Strange. Okay. Do.
Danny, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here.
Fuck you, narrator.
I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not.
You are!
I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time.
I will
this is someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about. Please, stop trying to make every decision by yourself. Now, I'm not asking for me, I'm asking for her.
Who's her? And how dare you bring up her?
This is it, Stanley. Your chance to redeem yourself, to put your work aside, to let her back into your life. She's been waiting.
Okay.
That's her, Stanley. You need to be the one to do this, to reach out to her. If you can truly place your faith in another, then pick up the phone.
Oh, Stanley, is that you? Hold on, sweetie. Sorry to keep you waiting. I'm just pulling the bread out of the oven. All right. Okay, there we go.
Honey, sweetie.
I want you to come in and tell me all about
your day.
Gotcha.
Fuck you, narrator.
Oh, come on. Did you actually think you had a loving wife? Who'd want to commit their life to you? I'm trying to make a point here, Stanley. I'm trying to get you to see something. Come inside. Let me show you what's really going on here.
I will murder you. Fast and without hesitation.
This is a very sad story about the death of a man named Stanley.
What?
Stanley is quite a boring fellow. He has a job that demands nothing of him, and every button that he pushes is a reminder of the inconsequential nature of his existence.
I'm not pressing it. I'll push all around.
Look at him there, pushing buttons, doing exactly what he's told to do. Now he's pushing a button. Now he's eating lunch. Now he's going home. Now he's coming back to work. One might even feel sorry for him, except that he's chosen this life.
I'm not pressing 2. F2. Fuck you. I'm not pressing it. He can't make me press it. Fine, fuck it.
But in his mind, in his mind.
I'm starting to hate this game. It's forcing me to do shit, and no one likes being forced to do shit. I swear. It's really starting to piss me off. But yeah.
He can go on fantastic adventures. From behind his desk, Stanley dreamed of wild expeditions into the unknown. Fantastic discoveries of new lands. It was wonderful. And each day that he returned to work was a reminder that none of it would ever happen to him.
Slam my head on the desk.
And so he began to fantasize about his own job. First, he imagined that one day while at work, he stepped up from his desk to realize that all of his co-workers, his boss, everyone in the building had suddenly vanished off the face of the earth.
Slam, slam,
the thought excited him terribly. So he went further. He imagined that he came to 2 open doors and that he could go through either. At last, choice. It barely even mattered what lay behind each door. The mere thought that his decisions would mean something was almost too wonderful to behold. As he wandered through this fantasy world, he began to fill it with many possible paths and destinations. Down one path lay an enormous round room with monitors and mind controls. And down.
I'm going to break his neck, to say the least, right now. I'm going to. I really am. I'm really feeling it right now. You know when you just feel that kind of thing? You know when you feel that, right? And you just realize you want to kill him? Yeah, that's me. And I will. Without hesitation, this motherfucker gonna die.
a yellow line that weaved in many directions, and down another was a game with a baby. And he called it the Stanley Parable. It was such a wonderful fantasy, and so in his head, he relived it again, and then again, and again, over and over, wishing beyond hope that it would never end, that he might always feel this free. Surely there's an answer down some new path, mustn't there be? Perhaps if he played just one more time. But there is no answer. How could there possibly
427.
Be? In reality, all he's doing is pushing the same buttons he always has. Nothing has changed. The longer he spends here, the more invested he gets, the more he forgets which life is the real one. And I'm trying to tell him this, that in this world, he can never be anything but an observer, that as long as he remains here, he's slowly killing himself. But he won't listen to me. He won't stop. Here. Watch this. Stanley, the next time the screen asks you to push a button, do not do it.
I'll just do him. Wow, this is boring. Okay,
You see? Can he just not hear me? How can I tell him in a way that he'll understand that every second he remains here, he's
I hate him. I hate him because there was nothing else I could have done there. There was nothing else I could have done. This is not proving any point other than just getting me angry, angry. I'm gonna fucking kill you. Thank you. Fuck you. Okay. I'm okay. I'm okay. I'm okay. I'm okay. Okay.
To kill himself. How can I get him to see what I see? How can I make him look at himself?
We're back.
I suppose I can't. Not in the way I want him to. But I don't make the rules. I simply play to my intended purpose, the same as Stanley. We're not so different, I suppose. I'll try once more to convey all this to him. I'm compelled to. I must. Perhaps, well, maybe this time he'll see. Maybe this time. And I tried again, and Stanley pushed a button. And I tried again, and Stanley pushed a button. And I
died. He just said, please die, so I was like, hey, fuck it, why not? Oh, wait, it's loading again. It's loading. Oh, I'm stuck here again. I'm done. This game is messing with my mind right now, I can't. Oh my god. This game is actually ruining my mind right now. My head hurts so much. Okay. So for now, thank you guys so much for watching this live stream. If you want to see more, hit that like button. Tell me down in the comments down below. I'm probably going to do one more of these. Just one more of these. And also, I don't know why it still has three up here and there's nobody watching. But whatever. Thank you guys so much for watching this live stream. I'll see you all in the next live stream. Remember, guys, hit that like button. Tell me down in the comments down below if you want to see more. Hit that share button, hit that subscribe button, and yeah, guys, thank you guys so much for watching. Remember, guys, make life your bitch every single day because you guys only got one life to live. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you all in the next live stream. This is Volta 5, signing out once again.